I'd gone to see a film, American in Paris. And it's a funny thing, I was sitting there watching that film, and suddenly I knew I was going to be there. I can't explain it, but I knew. And the next day I get a letter from Jack and June. They say if I'd come over and sing with Jack in the streets for 6 months, they'll pay my way. So I accepted.
We had a whole life separate from Derroll, but yet there was something missing. Derroll was missing. I mean, it wasn't only Jack, I missed him too.
And when we arrived in London, the train arrived, and I see Jack and June there, and there's a band playing and the whole thing, and I was, it was just a welcoming thing, and I get off, and nobody's even looking, and here comes Big Bill Broomsey.
And Derroll got off, thin, looked well, no banjo. And we were a little concerned because we had pre-booked a first night in London for Jack and Derroll to make their debut together. And Derroll said, nope, no banjo. We managed to borrow one from somebody who we knew, and we went to that club and played together that night.
Roll on, buddy, roll on.
I was a teenager, I was 18. This was London in the late 50s. It was pretty gloomy in London in the 50s. I mean, the music scene, it was just beginning to explode with rock and roll, and the skiffle boom was happening, which had come out of the jazz clubs. And I was part of a crowd of alternative young kids looking for something different.
I met wonderful people. And Jack and I singing in the streets like the old troubadours from the Moyen Âge, the Middle Ages, you know, getting around.
It was a lot of fun at first. The excitement of having Derroll there. Going to the clubs, going to the skiffle bars. And we got a very good booking at a very fancy nightclub called the Blue Angel.
Yeah, Jack and I did our first LP in London, the Ramblin Boys, and it was quite a success.
I was born in East Virginia, North Carolina, I did go. There I spied a fair young lady, and her name I did not know. I don't want your greenback dollar, I don't want your silver chain. All I want is your love, darling, won't you take me back again?
Derroll was approachable. Jack was an enigma. We couldn't really get close to Jack. But Derroll you could speak to, and he had an amazing influence on all of my generation. They introduced us to the music which we didn't really know about. We had this skiffle thing happening in London, which was kind of a very watered-down version of American folk tunes. But that they had become something that they wanted to be, and it made us realize that you can be what you want. The younger generation were being a bit browbeaten and told you can't have ideas beyond your station, as it were.
The man with the banjo is singing, his face lined with laughter, not age. His biggest success was survival and a watch from the side of the stage. With the banjo is laughing, the sound of his voice I can hear. A lifetime of love and of wandering, I never have heard it so clear.
Then we come on over to Paris, started kicking around in Paris.
And it was kind of a pleasant life. We'd work a little bit in the evening. We went out one night, and Derroll got out of the car and he went, man, I lost my banjo. And everybody went, you lost your banjo? And he was pretty drunk. And I was, what do you mean, Derroll, you've lost your banjo? Man, I lost my banjo. And he kept repeating it, and he was practically crying. Man, I lost my banjo. My banjo, that's like my wife. That's my life. That's my whole life. I lost my banjo. And something went like that in me. Something snapped in me. And at that point, I guess all the feelings that I'd had all summer about not wanting to be the nag and the nanny and the wife of two guys, and I said, that's it. And the next morning I said to Jack, that's it. He said, no, but what are we gonna do? I'll give Derroll half the money. He can have the money. He can do what he wants, but we're going on alone. I guess I've had 40 years of guilt over the situation. I did what I did at that moment out of frustration and anger and a feeling of helplessness. It was a terrible thing to do. It hurt Jack, it hurt Derroll, and I guess in a way it hurt me.
Now I ain't got no home, I'm just rambling round. A hard-working rambling man, I go from town to town. The police make it hard wherever I may roam, and I ain't got no home in this world anymore. Now as a farmer on the shares, and always I was poor, my crops I put into the banker's door.
And then Alex Campbell and I started busking around together, and we got a job up in the Cafe Contescarp.